What's going on, everybody? Zach Shrimp Room here, back again, taking like a little 2-week break and making videos. Been really busy with work and stuff happening to the house, whatever. So it's the weekend, we got some stuff to do. These two tanks back here, I need to switch out substrate. I want to set up, I don't remember the name of it. I got a little tank that I want to put a stand here. And it's got, we can show you because I can see it. So we have this tank here. It's actually like a, I think it's a Fluval, like 8.5 gallon tank. So I want this to kind of be like a mini display tank. And then I have this cabinet here that I want to put on top of it. I've had it on there before. And I can actually hold all that food in there and whatnot. So that's kind of the game plan. Also wanting to start a project and determining how much substrate you actually need in these tanks to buffer the pH. Because I don't want to, every year I don't want to break down a tank and put new substrate in. I know you can use like some Flip Aquatics back in the day. I don't know if he still does it or not. He'd actually just have containers in the tanks with substrate. And then once that time of year came around, he'd just pull out the container, dump out the substrate, and keep going with it. So I'm going to do a little experiment with that. First, I need to see how much substrate actually needs to buffer, but that's going to be another video. I am going on vacation next week, so I'm going to make some videos so that they come out while I'm gone. But yeah, let's get to it. All right, I've got the tank drained. I took out as much of the old substrate as I could. It's not going to be perfect. I don't want to drain entirely everything. Got new soil here. I just put everything in a little bucket. All the old soil, that's kind of my shrimp room trash can. And then I've got the old water from that tank. I gotta make sure this stays somewhat. When you're moving plants around, you're gonna let them sit out for a little bit. You wanna make sure you keep the leaves damp or they'll dry out really fast, a lot faster than you think. So I got the driftwood, the chola wood, and whatever moss was in there. I always put whatever I take out of the tank, decoration wise, in a container with water. It's hard to tell, but there are shrimp in here. If you were to just set it out on a, you know, like on a lid or something, they will die. And then I have all the shrimp in that tank in this container. So the next step is I'm letting the I can't decide whether if I want to put the substrate in first and then the water. I might put the water back in first, let it settle back down, all of the debris and water dust, and then I'll put the substrate on top so it's a clean look, because I don't want all this dirty stuff on top of the tank. I mean, I could siphon out everything, but I want to try to save as much of the water as I can. So I think I'm gonna do that. I think I'm gonna fill up the tank with the old tank water, let it settle. I'll put the new substrate in, and then we'll get everything back into the tank. Let's do it. Well, my plan didn't quite work out the way I wanted it to. I even tried putting in the new substrate pretty nicely and still got pretty cloudy. But substrate is in there. I think I put in 15 to 20 cups worth. So a decent amount. It's a little high over here, but I'll level everything out once it everything calms down so it can get dirty again. And then this tank has been having a problem with the GH rising. So I'm gonna top it off with an extra 20% of fresh RO water try to get this tank under control. I know I said I was gonna do this tank as well. My Super Tigers. But I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna refill this tank and see. I'm gonna pull all the shadow pandas and black pandas out of there and throw them in the main 40. And then I might drain the rest of these and actually use them for my larger colonies. Like I might move these Snow Whites and Golden Bees, the Royal, Orange Eye Royal Blue Tigers, I'll probably end up moving. I would like to get a big, I'd like to get a 40 going with my Shadow Pandas. If I can produce that stuff in larger amounts, that'd be awesome. Well, I'm gonna cut the video off there. Don't really want it to be dragging around, but if I do end up doing stuff with these 20s, I'll make another video. And like I said, at the end of this week, I'm gonna be out of town for a week. So if I do anything more this weekend, I'll have it set up so stuff comes out while I'm gone. Yeah. And then if you're watching this and haven't seen the other video, I'm testing to see how much substrate you need to buffer a tank. I have this, I think it's a swear, I think it's an 8.5 gallon tank. And then I have this other 10 gallon tank that I filled clay, clay pots up with soil to try to avoid having to change out a whole tank worth of soil. But that's another project in itself. As for now, in this video, that's it. If you guys like and subscribe, that's nice, Zach. If you guys like these kind of videos, make sure you like and subscribe. And we're already over 300 subs. That's crazy. Thanks to you guys. Yeah. All right. Well, I'll catch you guys next time. Thanks.